Здравствуйте, друзья! Мы с вами сегодня беседуем с Гейбриэлом, который работает в Foothill College. Это такой community college, очень известный, очень большой. У них основной кампус находится в городе Лос-Алтос. Вот буквально это наши соседи. И Гейбриэл расскажет вам о программе по изучению английского языка, которая у них есть для иностранцев. И я думаю, что многие люди, которые находятся в Кремниевой долине, они как бы могут с пользой к этому делу обратиться. So, Gabriel, what is that program about?
So our program here is we offer free English classes, English as a second language classes, to adults in the community. Our courses are 100% free, and we also provide college-level textbooks for the courses as well. And we have two levels that are free. One, we have level one ESL, which is for basic English. So those who maybe speak a little bit of English or understand very basic English, they can attend that class and they can learn about reading, writing, and grammar. And then our level two course is for those who are maybe intermediate level English and who really want to learn a little bit more about grammar and sharpen their reading skills and their conversational skills as well.
But is there any limitation on who is eligible for the class?
Perfect, yeah. So we take any and all students. You do not have to be a resident. You do not have to have a social security number or a visa. All we ask is that you apply online, and you don't have to provide any information other than an email and maybe a home address or any address that we can send you flyers or mail. And really cool thing about our courses are that they're non-credit, so you don't get a grade for them. Mm-hmm. You can take them as many times as you'd like. All of our courses last for about 12 weeks. We're on the quarter system. So you can repeat the class over and over if you'd like. If you're not comfortable going to level two, you can take level one again. Or if you're in level two and you want to keep taking it, that's fine. And there's no requirement for attendance. A lot of our students work and have families, so they come in a little late, or maybe they can't come in every day. That's totally fine. It's totally up to you when you'd like to come in.
So it is a physical kind of attendance. It's not like online or being recorded, and so you can watch it anytime you have time to watch it, or it's a physical classroom.
So currently we do have physical classrooms in the Sunnyvale campus, both in the mornings and in the evenings, but we actually have an online course that we're working on, and I believe that's going to be available coming up soon, and I can give you the information for that.
But the financial part, who is financing the course?
Sure. So we actually have a grant from the state of California that is funding this whole entire program. So the student never pays for anything for the books or for the courses. However, once you're a student, you can pay $10 to have an ID card from Foothill. And if you have that ID card, you get access to the VTA transportation system here. You also get access to some health care, some legal services, library access, tutoring services, and some discounts in the area as well.
So let me make sure I understand you right. So if you have that student ID, you mean you don't have to pay for a bus, or it's free for you now?
It's free for you, correct.
Wow, okay. Then I'm just wondering why not everybody is a student. I mean, if you pay $10, it's interesting. So you get public transportation for free. You mentioned health services. What's in there? What's included?
Sure. So we have some medical services on campus in Los Altos that students can go ahead and take advantage of. We have a health center here where you can get some free medication, some free advice for medical attention, and we also have free dental cleaning here for students as well.
But does it cover any emergency things, like, let's say, surgery, or God knows, things happen, so what?
Sure, no, we don't have medical services like that for anything serious, but for a basic For basic circumstances, we do have some services available.
Okay, including medications.
Yeah, so we have some medications available at the at the medical services center.
Just curious. Let's say within that program, or maybe outside of that program, are there any programs with for students with diabetes, type 2, type 1, any services for diabetics?
You know, I'm not quite sure, but I can definitely look into that and I can provide you with that information afterwards. I haven't heard of anything, but I can double check with our departments and see if we do have services for that.
Okay, so if we move to the practical part, so let's say I want to get enrolled. So what do I do next?
So the easiest way to get enrolled is to just show up to any class and the teacher will help you sign in right then and there. Most of our courses are at Sunnyvale, the Sunnyvale Center. It's right across the street from the Google Tech Corners. You can walk to Google Tech Corners, it's right across the street. And if you go there, there's only one front desk, and the people at the front desk will help you sign in for the class. You can go check out the class, and if you like it, you can enroll right then and there, and if you don't, totally fine. And there is no placement test either. So if you think that you're level one, you can go visit the level one course. If that's too basic for you, you can go visit the level two course. And the same thing, if you go to the level two course and it's too advanced for you, you can go right back to level one. Students do it all the time. They jump back and forth.
Okay, but you mentioned that enrollment is available online, so you can actually go and do it online.
Absolutely. So like I mentioned, the easiest way is to show up in person because they can help you with the online application. The second way is to go and apply online yourself. The link for that is www.foothill.edu/apply.
That's it.
That's it, yeah. And then once you're there, there's a little green button that says apply now, and then it'll walk you through the steps on how to apply.
But, I mean, the word apply doesn't say anything about specifically that program, so...
Correct. So once you apply, you apply to our college, and then we will email you an identification number. So you're right, there's two steps to it. The first step is to apply. The second step is when you get your identification number, your student identification number, then you go right back in to the link and they'll have a link there for you, and you can enroll in the course that you want. So you can automatically go in and say, I want ESL level 1 or ESL level 2.
So that is why it makes sense to really stop by and do it with somebody's assistance.
Yeah. So we highly advise that because the whole application is in English, and sometimes it's a little difficult and tricky to navigate through.
Let me ask you a provocative question. Let's say tomorrow people watch that video and 500 people stop by to enroll. Are you able to accommodate 500 people?
Well, that's a great... Okay, one, that's a great question.
Yeah.
And two, that's a good problem to have.
Yeah.
So, I agree. Yeah. So right now we do have four or five classes running. But I'll tell you what, if 500 people do show up, I know for a fact that we will accommodate all those people, maybe not this quarter, but the following quarter, because we will go hire those instructors and open up as many classes as we need to get everybody in.
Then another question, which kind of is surprising. I mean, with such a great program, with so many side benefits, why don't you have a crowd lining up, you know, to get enrolled? What's the problem?
Sure. Yeah, that's a great question. So I'm fairly new to my position. I've only been here around 4 or 5 months. Before I got here, there was no outreach for this program. It was just a program for some courses, and they were doing okay. They had a good attendance. But since I've arrived, I've been going out and meeting new people and different organizations like yourself. I've been spreading the word, and we've been seeing a significant increase on our enrollment. So we have opened up new classes, brought in new instructors to accommodate the new students, but our goal is to grow even larger now, and that's what we hope to do.
So basically your job is to make it larger, increase the enrollment.
Absolutely correct.
Okay. I think it's very valuable. Besides that specific video which we are doing, Do you have any maybe posters or I don't know something to put on the wall, you know?
Oh, absolutely. I have a couple flyers that I can share with you that tell about our courses, tell a little bit more about the perks that our students get and the
yes.
services that they're available for. I can provide you all that information.
Now, is it available in the file or?
Yeah, I have.
So I can print. Yeah, PDF. Yeah, if you just Skype it to me, so we will print it out and post in our office as well.
Oh, excellent. Yeah, I would appreciate that. One other thing that I would like to mention is we are open to creating new classes based on the interests of our students. So if our students, you know what, I'm in the computer industry or I'm in engineering and I need to learn English specifically for that field.
Yes.
If we have enough people, like around 20 or more that want to take that class, we can create a class like that.
Let's say English for computer science jobs.
Exactly. That's exactly what we can do. And right now we don't have too many people that are interested in that,
mm-hmm.
but if some of the people that you work with would like that, we could say, oh, definitely. We can do an English class that helps you with the terminology and vocabulary for computer.
My thinking is, I'm not sure if you are facing requests like that, but I would say if you have a class which teaches people how to fill out an employment application, God, if you do it first time, you will die there. I mean, so many things, you don't even know what they mean. When it comes to W-2 and 1099, when it comes to hourly or annual or permanent versus temporary, and it's so confusing.
Yeah. Yeah, that's definitely another class that we're thinking about opening.
Benefits. Look at the job offer. Look at their benefits policy.
Yeah.
If you didn't do it before, I mean, there is no way you understand anything in there.
Yeah, exactly. And so, and you know, I speak fluent English, and sometimes I have trouble myself understanding those benefit documents and everything. So
yeah,
I think
it's
you
true.
Join that class too. You know.
Okay. Okay. So Gabriel, it is a pleasure to talk to you, and I hope we will refer some people, you know, over time. And I will definitely, you know what, that recording which we are making, it will be in my Facebook account, it will be in my Twitter account, so I have quite few thousand, maybe more people, and maybe 5, 6, 10 people will watch that recording within a couple of months, so.
Excellent. I would love to provide you with my email and my office phone number. If anyone has questions, please send them to talk to me, and I can help them. I've done this quite a few times already, and once we get them to the Sunnyvale Center,
if that is the case, just Skype it to me, and I will put it into the description to that video. And so, definitely.
Perfect. That sounds great.
Okay. Thank you very much, and I hope we can create some value together. I mean, you in your own way, and me in my own way. So, but. Together it will create more value.
Absolutely, sir. Thank you so much for the opportunity. I truly appreciate it.
Thank you very much.